Hey guys, welcome back to the Dimcat channel. Quick little update on what's been going on with the George Floyd situation. First, Floyd Mayweather has volunteered to pay for the funeral, and I think that's absolutely awesome. It's good to see Floyd Money Mayweather using some of his money for something that's meaningful. Although I don't blame him for buying all those fancy cars and all those nice things. He worked hard for that stuff, okay? He worked really hard for that, but it's good to see him supporting somebody who needs that support. You know, a lot of times these black athletes, they're taking money from the community. People are supporting them by paying for their events and everything, but it's good to see athlete actually support people in his own community. So that's pretty awesome. Okay, the officer Chauvin, the officer had his knee on George Floyd's neck. He was kneeling down on his neck for almost 9 minutes. He continued 2 minutes after the guy was clearly unconscious, which is ridiculous. This officer, his charges has been upgraded to second degree murder. Now in Minnesota, with second degree murder, the prosecutors must prove that he intended to actually kill George Floyd. That's what they need to do, which I don't think should be too difficult given the fact that the guy was in handcuffs. He wasn't really resisting, and then looked like he was resisting. He was pinned down, clearly under control. He had two other officers putting pressure on him, keeping him down, and you had Officer Chauvin putting his knee, just kneeling down on his neck for almost 9 minutes. I mean, to me, 9 minutes, okay, you didn't intend to kill somebody by having your knee pressed down on their neck, blocking their airway for almost 9 minutes, and then the guy goes unconscious and you continue for another 2 minutes. It's a total of 9 minutes, 2 minutes where he's completely unconscious. If you didn't intend to kill the guy, what exactly were you intending to do? It doesn't make any sense. If the guy's unconscious, how can you say, oh, we're trying to control the suspect? The dude's out. He's in handcuffs. Why don't you just turn him over and get him up? A long time ago. You didn't have to do that for 9 minutes. So I think they have a pretty good case here. The whole thing's on camera. Now, initially, I didn't think the other three officers should have been charged. I think they should have been fired. But what I'm seeing now is another angle. You have two officers who had George Floyd pinned down, and the third officer, Chauvin, actually has his knee on his neck. So you got three officers who have him pinned down. I see why there are other two guys being charged too, because they're actually holding him down while this guy is putting his knee into his neck for almost 9 minutes. I get that. Then you have the Asian guy who was talking to the crowd, who was protesting, or obviously saying, hey, what you're doing is wrong. I can see all the three cops being charged. He was just incompetent. He was a willing participant. He really was. Should he be charged? Well, I mean, that's debatable. I will say this. I think it should be first degree murder. I think when you have your knee down on a guy who's clearly not able to move, and you have your knee on his neck blocking his airway for 9 minutes, okay, your intent is to end that person's life. You're blocking their airway, especially when the person's completely unconscious. How can you justify continuing to block their airway? I don't see why this guy wasn't charged with first degree murder. But we'll see how this actually develops. I mean, with third degree murder, you don't even have to prove that the guy intended to kill the person. So with this second degree murder, the maximum is what, 40 years? But typically people get somewhere around 10 or 12 years in Minnesota, from my understanding. If this officer is convicted, he'll probably maybe get 2 years, if that, or something like that. I don't know. It's not gonna be 40 years. And here's the deal. You have people protesting all over the country, even in Europe, all right? I totally understand that. I totally understand the frustration. But you had the riots, people looting and tearing up their own town. Oh, actually, in Minnesota, in Minneapolis, there's reports that there's a lot of out-of-towners who were arrested on that first day of rioting and looting. But anyway, you're not going to get a real change in behavior until criminals with badges. I'm not really talking about just regular cops. I call them criminals with badges because, you know, they're criminals with badges. I mean, just because they're criminals with badges doesn't mean they deserve to be protected by other cops. That's what I don't get. I understand why cops want to protect other cops. But when somebody is acting so far out of the norm, when somebody's acting to the point where they're clearly hurting the community, I don't see how you can really justify protecting that person. That person becomes criminal with a badge. Okay, it's the difference between the cops and the criminals with a badge. That's my opinion. And the police, the good cops, have got to step up and hold these people accountable. Okay, got to treat them like any other criminal, frankly. Anyway, there has to be consequences. People have to see that, okay, if these criminals with badges act in a nefarious manner, a criminal manner, they're going to be held accountable. That means going to prison. This guy should be charged with murder. He should be convicted, and he should get those type of consequences. When they start giving murderers who also have badges the death penalty and things like that, when there's some serious consequences, they're doing 20, 30 years for killing people, completely unjustified murder. When other officers see that, when people see that, you're going to see a change in behavior. But right now, yeah, too many people believe that they can do whatever the hell they want to do as long as they have a badge. Okay, that's a serious problem right there. So anyway, my experience with law enforcement has been fine. I haven't had any trouble with law enforcement. All right, unemployment. I did talk about how this extra unemployment benefits were really incentivizing people to stay home and not really work. But I read something on Zero Hedge that said that about a third of these people who lost their jobs because of this crisis are not actually receiving their unemployment benefits. We read about how a lot of people were struggling to actually file for unemployment benefits. You have 40 million people or so filing for unemployment benefits, but a lot of people aren't really getting their benefits. So it's a complete mess right there. Maybe they'll... it's crazy. 2020 has been crazy. Thank you guys for watching. Thank you for listening. And don't forget, the future belongs to those who prepare for it today.